cannot let you leave without telling your favorite George Niang story. All right. And it can't be a positive one. Like, we don't need, whenever I talk about George, I still love to tweet out the picture that he was so dumb to give me of. I don't know if you've seen it.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
The one with him as a kid. He wrote Michigan, but he misspelled it with his kind of flabby gullet as a 12-year-old George Niang.
Yeah.
Like, why would he be dumb enough to get, like, that's going to go out every year. Every year I'm going to tweet that out.
Well, I'll tell you this. So I was fortunate last year. There was a game in Utah that, you know, the Jazz were playing against the Nuggets. Now, mind you, I've been in this bubble as I've gotten the Iowa State job, and you're just like head down working, head down working. So I get to Salt Lake. I'm with Coach Byers, who's on our staff, and we're going to watch a game. It's George Niang and Matt Thomas playing against Monte Morris. And then one of our other former players, Dustin Hogue, came down and met us, and Naz Long came to meet us. It was really cool to get everybody together.
Yeah.
So I get there, and Dennis Lindsay, the GM of Utah, he comes to me and goes, "Hey, I got a few items for you." And I had no idea that George Niang's nickname was the minivan in Utah. And so he brings this sweatshirt, and it's got George's face with like the minivan behind it. Right. And so, like, I had no idea that was a thing. Now, trust me, I'm not into body shaming, but George, based on at points in time what his body may have been judged by others, some would be surprised that he's had the success he has. Now, when you see how he works every day, how tough, how smart, how competitive, you're just like, yeah, you don't ever see that. Like, there's, you don't coach multiple George Niangs, right? Like, his, the ingredients he has are so special. But what I will say is, I'm wearing this hoodie as we're walking to the game from our hotel, and I'm wearing it at the game because I'm just like dying how funny this is that I have the minivan. And people are coming up to me, "Hey, we love the minivan, minivan." And other people have the shirt on, and I'm like, I didn't know it was a thing till I got there. And then I'm like obsessed minivan. So like when I'm seeing other people now, I'm yelling, "Minivan, the minivan." So it was pretty cool.
Remarkable. You know, the thing with George again is, he's just got a way of connecting with people so well, right? Like, he does everything the right way. He obviously worked to get to where he is and to be able to stay in the league. It looked for a while like he may not. But he's just so good with people, with being real. And that's hard to do, right? It's a difficult thing to do is I've always said that I can't do it. I offend too many people. George really does it.
Well, I think the two things is, you know, he's so real based on how he works, how he does things, how he treats people, please and thank yous, hold doors. Like, he's a complete gentleman, right? And so everything about George is authentic, and he's comfortable in his own skin. And he knows, and he knew when he wanted to embark on the journey of the NBA, what an uphill battle that would be. But I remember even when he first started working out with NBA players, and he would say, "I got to speed up my shot. I can't get this shot off anymore. I'm going to have to play with my hands higher on defense." He's so self-aware that he eliminates his weaknesses, where some guys say, "Well, I can still take that. I can make that. I'm better than this guy." He has such a humility to him and self-awareness that he works tirelessly to eliminate weaknesses. But as a human being, there's not a better guy. There's not, I mean, there's no better ambassador for our program. I mean, he was with us in Barclays. He came down for a championship game in the preseason NIT. He was here in the summer for camps. He's here in the fall for football games. Like, George Niang put his stamp on this program that didn't just last for the 4 years he was here. It will impact us for many years going forward. But that's just who George is as a person. If you come in touch with him, he has that impact on you for a long time.
Yeah, you will not find a better human being than George Niang. I know, you know, it's funny doing my job. You're supposed to be objective, right? It's hard. It's hard to be objective when you've known these kids since. You know, I remember the first time I ever saw him, I went to Tilton for open gym. And I'm there, obviously, to see New Orleans and Wayne Selden. I'm not there. I didn't even know who George Niang was. And in between games, I'm talking to New Orleans, you know, just for a few minutes on the sideline. And all of a sudden, this dude yells at Nerlens to get the hell back in the game. And I'm like, who is this chubby little friggin' kid? Like, and I looked at Nerlens. I'm like, who is that? He's like, yeah, it's George Niang. I'm like, you know, I think he was a full pay kid then. I think it was his first year. He was full pay. And then I started to watch him. I'm like, who is this asshole? You know, who's yelling at Nerlens and me to finish off? And the dude never came off the court the entire day. He won every single game. And that's kind of how it was at BABC. And listen, you got a little lucky, to be honest. You did get a little lucky getting in there as early as you did, because if you didn't, it was going to be a battle to keep him.
Well, the one thing I'll say is George hurt recruiting when he was here, because when we'd have recruits that would come on campus, whether it was they wanted to work out or get shots or play pickup with our guys, George was so competitive. You know how, like, if your guys are going to play, as every coach, you kind of like, hey, you know, maybe give the recruit an extra shot or two or whatever. Like, George can't do it. Like, he's the guy that's going to, like, the family volleyball game and spiking the ball on his niece's face and breaking her nose. Like,
he tried to beat my daughter in ping pong at my house when my daughter was like 10. She beat his ass. And I don't let him forget it. Terrible ping pong player. Terrible.